Hey guys, my name is David Kwan, and this is the second part to a series of videos in which I talk about video games and how they tell their stories. The first video, I talked about Half-Life. I thought that was a really great starting point because I consider Half-Life as one the pioneer in the Half-Life series as a whole, as a pioneer in having this genre, first-person shooter, tell their stories through the first-person perspective. Doesn't use any cutscenes, but simply has the player explore the world in first-person view mode, and you meet characters who will tell you about the story, and the non-playable characters talk to you, and you explore the world in first-person view mode, and that's how you learn the game's the plot or the setting and the atmosphere. That's the method that Half-Life uses to tell the story. Doesn't use any cutscenes. Just utilizes that method. And one of the also key feature of Half-Life storytelling is that the character that you play as, Gordon Freeman, doesn't ever talk throughout the entire experience. He's a silent character. So that is, in essence, how Half-Life 1 and 2 and Half-Life Episode 1 and Episode 2 tell their stories. One thing that becomes differentiates Half-Life 1 from its later sequels is that the later sequels have the AI companion, Alex Bance. So she's constantly talking to you throughout the whole experience, and she's the one that's reacting to what's going on around the world. And so that's another method that the Half-Life universe utilizes. This video is about Bioshock, though. Bioshock is, in a way, is an evolution, I think, from Half-Life storytelling method. It takes a little bit more steps more. It takes more steps. I don't want to say forward because I don't want to feel like I'm saying that Bioshock is a better game. This is not that type of comparison. I just want to say it utilizes more different methods to that differentiate storytelling from Half-Life way of storytelling. Let's start with the similarities though. One big similarity is how both Half-Life series and Bioshock 1 and 2 introduce the player to the game world. In both series, the player doesn't just start in the setting. They're introduced to it. They start from somewhere outside of the setting. Gordon Freeman doesn't start in Black Mesa Lab. He takes a train and goes into it. Just like that concept, Bioshock 1, you start in an airplane. And it blows up. You land in the ocean, and you're introduced to the world of Rapture that way. You don't just start out in Rapture. And you come to learn the world of the setting of Rapture bit by bit. You come to learn what it's like, you know, that it's gone to shit. You start observing things slowly and slowly and slowly. So that, in a way, is similar. What makes, I think, Rapture so different from Black Mesa or the other settings in Half-Life 1 is, well, first, it feels uniquely original and just crazy. You know, the first question that you automatically think is like, how is this something like this possible? A city, underwater city, this is insane. That is also a key component. Another key component is Half-Life 1 was more like a puzzle. Trying to figure out how to get from A to B was a big part of Half-Life 1. Bioshock, that's not really the case. You always know where you're going to go. But the game directs you where you should be going and what you should be doing. And the game tells you bit by bit about Rapture. So you come to learn about the setting that you're in slowly and slowly and slowly and more and more. So that's kind of a differentiating factor, I think. Also, Bioshock is not a silent game like Half-Life was. Half-Life is a pretty quiet game. You get to meet some characters here and there, and they talk to you, but majority of the time, you are exploring the universe of Half-Life by yourself. There's no dialogue and there's no chatter. There's a lot of, you know, gunfire from the guns you fire, the groans and the screeching sounds of aliens you fight. Oh, you know, but there's not much dialogue in Half-Life. And that's what, you know, that's I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying that's the way Half-Life tells the story. Bioshock is not a silent game. Everyone is talking to you at all the time. There's audio logs to pick up, and they'll once you hit play, even if you're moving around and shooting things up, it's going to continue talking. Atlas, Andrew Ryan, all these different characters continue talking to you as you're doing things. It's not a very silent game, but that's how it tells a story. And that's why I feel like Bioshock, you can really understand the things going on in the world of Rapture, much more so than something like Half-Life, where because there is so less dialogue, you kind of have to figure things out. Half-Life story is more like trying to figure out a puzzle. Bioshock is much more directed. Everything is for the narrative. Every single gameplay aspect in Bioshock 2 is for the narrative. I think this is something that Irrational Games does a lot. In all the Bioshock games, and this includes Bioshock Infinite, the gameplay mechanics are a part of the story. For example, there is no game over in Bioshock. I mean, you can turn that on, but on default setting, there is no game over. You die, you respawn in the beta chamber or beta chamber. That's a gameplay mechanic, but that's explained in the game story as well. Every single mechanic in Bioshock universe is explained by the story, which I think is an amazing feat to have done. So that's also a very unique thing about Bioshock 1 and 2 and Infinite. Those are, I think, the ways that Bioshock tells a story. I think still to this day, Bioshock 1 and 2 are such unique games in this medium, and especially in this genre. I really wish that Bioshock had a bigger impact in this genre, because I want to see more games, more first-person shooter games in particular, have this strong narrative focus. That would have been amazing thing to see have happened in the gaming landscape. But unfortunately, the only other game that is like Bioshock is Bioshock 2. Bioshock Infinite is very similar, but it is very different. And a lot of it is in a good way. But the whole Bioshock experience, the way it tells the story, you can really only find with, Bioshock 2 and Bioshock Infinite. The other first-person shooter games don't really do this. So this is a very unique franchise in the medium. But the way it tells its story is pretty similar to Half-Life. It's just that it has a lot of ideas that are more steps from that, such as the audio logs, such as the beta chamber, incorporating gameplay mechanics into the story, which is amazing. Also, I forgot to mention this. Bioshock has what I would like to call story moments. In Half-Life series, there's hardly any story moments. What I mean by that is when, you're still in first-person perspective, but the action isn't there. It's just the characters are talking to you, and you can just move around while the story is being told to you. Those are the story moments that I would like to say. Half-Life series doesn't have many of those. Bioshock does, and not only does it have a good amount of them, but it's also very restrictive for the narrative. For example, the plot twist in Bioshock 1 is a very restrictive story moment. In fact, it's more like a cutscene, because you can't really, the control is taken away from you, you can't do anything. And that's for a narrative purpose. And I think, especially because Bioshock has such a compelling narrative and a compelling setting, those story moments are extremely restrictive, but they are effective at presenting the player to this amazing story and kind of immersing the player into the universe of Rapture. So that's pretty much all I want to say about Bioshock 1 and 2, I think. Next video will be, I think it's going to be a short one on Bioshock Infinite. Maybe it won't be, because Bioshock Infinite is a pretty complex story telling game. I don't know, but that's what the next video will be. This video is just on Bioshock 1 and 2. If you want to leave any comments about really anything about Bioshock's 1 and 2 story, or even Half-Life, feel free to do so. If you think I left out anything to talk about with Bioshock 1 and 2 story, feel free to leave comments. So, yeah, hope you enjoy. Cheers.